Hi, I'm John, and I want to tell you about some changes we have made in the Pardome client. Some changes involve how the icons for devices and macros are handled, how you can delete icons, create icons or shortcuts, and how the windows are handled. And I'm going to show you a little bit about the utility measurements which are added in the server. So first of all, we on the right top had a window bar which shows showed open windows just stacked below each other, or growing over the complete bar. Well, we have changed it, and I will open some windows to show. And as you can see, there are a couple of windows open right now, and on the right top you can see these windows which are opened, and by pressing the right button you can scroll to the right, you can move it to the right, you can scroll it to the left, you can bring windows to front as well you usually did. Another change we have made is within the center of the bar. It already did show the time and date, and we have added now the user presence. So when you click now home, for example, now I'm home, a new window will pop up and you can change your presence here, for example at work, you are away or at home. As you can see, there's a keypad over here. Well, this is for future references. When the server supports key coding, so you have to enter a code to change the presence, and a little window with this one will pop up, and so you have to fill in a code before your presence can be changed. Another change is that when you press the time or the date, you will get a simple window showing the clock with the current time, a little date field showing the days, today, and when the server supports alarms, it will also be shown over here. Another change we've made on the desktop is it's now easier to change your desktop. So when you press this icon over here, you'll get settings. The display settings are merged together. So for example, when you change your background, you can simply choose an image, open, and your image is being changed. I will go back to that one. Just save the settings and you're done. And other changes we've made is, for example, in the device list. This was an ordinary list, and when you clicked an device, a new window will pop up. Well, this has been changed. When you click a device right now, you will get you will get the device controls in the right part of the list. So when you click around, you will see other devices. What we have added is filtering, so you can filter your devices on location or category. For example, if I choose another category, measurement devices, then only this one will pop up. When I do lighting, only the devices which do lighting will pop up. I can filter on location, well, the main floor, or unknown locations, and it will show only the devices at that location. What we also changed is the appearance of the device. As you can see right here, and when I click it to open it right here, this was quite a big window. This has been changed to a smaller window. It shows the controls, and if there are a lot of controls, this scroll button will work. You can click about device to get some information about the device. It shows the name and the location, if known. Another change we've made is with the media list. It shows almost exactly the same window as the devices window, which you can also filter. You can filter on player type and XBMC. Well, that's the only one I have right now. And works the same as previously. Another change we've made is how to handle the shortcuts and how to create them. This is done with interaction with the server. So the shortcuts you see here are in fact favorite devices on the server, which I can show you. Device management devices. Here you can see the BlinkM. Yes, it's a favorite. Lights next to TV is also a favorite. So when I change it over here, favorite no, and I save it, and I will change this one also. Go to no, save it. When I go back to the client, you can see these icons here are gone. So you can see that only favorite devices will show up as an icon over here. Well, you don't need the server to create a favorite one. Here, press and hold. What you can do is drag it to the desktop, release it. Well, here the icon is shown. And when I refresh this one, you can see here it is created as a favorite device. So when I add this, press and hold, put it over here, refresh, you see a favorite over here. So when I click it to open it, you can see this, and it's exactly the same. Another change we've made is how to delete these. It supports drag and drop. So what you can do is just click and drag it. And here's a new icon, which is a little dustbin. And when you hover over it, it will light up. Release the device, and you can see it's removed over here, and again no favorite anymore. And I will remove this one, and also no favorite. We've made also some additions. The server now supports utility measurements. The client has this already partly integrated to it. When I click this button, this for utility measurement, it will open some meters. It show the current wattage, total liters of water, and cubic meters gas used. And one of the nice features we also have added is on the top over here, you can place widget icons. Well, widget icons are in fact small versions of bigger meters like this, or device data, which will can appear here, and other stuff. And how to add these is just go to one of these, press and move, and you can choose if you want it on the left side or on the right side. And you can see the bar is green when it accepts it, so I will lose it. And you can see it's added here. And on the other side, I want this one. So you can see it's turning green. Well, drop it, and these icons are now on the left and on the right. It supports real-time updates. So at the moment on the server, when it changes on the server, it also changes in the client. To get more information about your utility usages, what you can do is you can go to this icon, you can click it, and it will pop up with a graph which shows last hour, last day, last week, last month. I think you will get the picture. And it also shows the same meter again. And well, in the future you can click or press these bars, and then you will see the selected value, and also other values will be added, like costs, high usage, low usage, etc. These widget icons can also be removed. You just drag it out of here. As you can see, you cannot put it back. Go to the dustbin, and it is deleted. It also has some protection that you can't add a second one again. As you can see, widget has already been added. Another change has done with the macros. Well, they work as they used to, and pressing them will activate a specific macro. But also this one now supports the creating of shortcuts. Evening, let this one, afternoon. So when I check these two on the server, let's see the automation macros. You can see we have here favorite macro evening, favorite macro afternoon. And we can also now run them from the desktop. So when you click it, run macro evening and run macro afternoon. And also when I delete or set these on the server as a non-favorite or I delete them, they will also be removed off the client. So these are some little additions and changes we have made. I wanted to show you. And well, we keep on continue working on it, of course. And come back with a video later on when there is a possibility to add these widgets also to the desktop as some floating information. So thank you for watching, and we'll post an update really soon. Bye bye.